Pompholyx eczema, also known as dyshidrotic eczema, is a skin condition characterized by small, fluid-filled blisters that typically develop on the hands and feet. This type of eczema can be quite distressing due to its intense itching and discomfort. In this video, we will guide you through the causes, signs, and symptoms of Pompholyx eczema, explore the diagnosis and differential diagnosis processes, delve into treatment and prevention options, share practical home remedy tips, and address frequently asked questions. By the way, welcome to our channel. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe. Causes of Pompholyx eczema. The causes of Pompholyx eczema are not entirely clear, but several factors may contribute to its development. These include genetic factors. Pompholyx eczema often runs in families, suggesting a genetic predisposition to the condition. Individuals with a family history of eczema are more likely to develop Pompholyx eczema themselves. Environmental triggers. Various environmental factors can trigger flare-ups of Pompholyx eczema. These include exposure to allergens, such as pollen or pet dander, irritants, like detergents or metals, stress, and weather changes, extreme temperatures or humidity. Immunological and skin barrier dysfunction. Pompholyx eczema involves abnormal immune responses in the skin, leading to inflammation and blister formation. Additionally, impaired skin barrier function makes individuals more susceptible to irritation and inflammation, contributing to the development of the condition. Symptoms of Pompholyx eczema. Pompholyx eczema manifests through distinctive symptoms affecting the skin on the hands and feet. Fluid-filled blisters. Small, clear blisters develop, often clustered together, and are filled with fluid. These blisters are a characteristic feature of Pompholyx eczema. Itching and discomfort. Intense itching and burning sensations accompany the appearance of blisters, causing significant discomfort and distress to individuals affected by the condition. Redness and inflammation. The skin around the blisters becomes red and inflamed, indicating inflammation in the affected area. Dryness and peeling. As the blisters heal, the skin may become dry, cracked, and begin to peel or flake, further exacerbating discomfort and irritation. Differential diagnosis of Pompholyx eczema. Differential diagnosis involves distinguishing Pompholyx eczema from similar skin conditions based on specific symptoms and characteristics. Contact dermatitis. Contact dermatitis, triggered by exposure to irritants or allergens, shares symptoms such as redness, itching, and blistering with Pompholyx eczema, though it's provoked by specific substances contacting the skin. Scabies and dyshidrotic dermatitis. Conditions like scabies and dyshidrotic dermatitis closely resemble Pompholyx eczema, presenting with intense itching, redness, and small blisters, often affecting the hands and feet. Herpes simplex virus, HSV, and impetigo. HSV infections and impetigo may mimic Pompholyx eczema, manifesting as fluid-filled blisters, but HSV blisters occur in clusters and are painful, while impetigo may exhibit honey-colored crusted lesions, indicating a bacterial infection. Accurate diagnosis requires thorough evaluation by a healthcare professional to differentiate Pompholyx eczema from other potential causes based on symptoms, medical history, and additional tests if necessary. Treatment options of Pompholyx eczema. Treatment for Pompholyx eczema focuses on symptom relief, inflammation reduction, and prevention of flare-ups. Topical medications. Topical corticosteroids and calcineurin inhibitors are commonly prescribed to reduce inflammation and itching. These medications come in various forms and strengths and should be used as directed by a healthcare professional. Emollients and moisturizers. Regular application of fragrance-free emollients and moisturizers helps hydrate the skin, soothe irritation, and prevent dryness, which can worsen symptoms of Pompholyx eczema. Oral medications. In severe cases, oral antihistamines or corticosteroids may be prescribed to provide quick relief from inflammation and itching. However, long-term use of oral steroids is generally avoided due to potential side effects. Phototherapy and immune suppressing medications. Phototherapy exposes the skin to controlled amounts of UV light to reduce inflammation and itching. In severe or refractory cases, immune-suppressing medications like methotrexate or cyclosporine may be prescribed. Trigger avoidance and wet dressings. Identifying and avoiding triggers such as stress, allergens, or irritants can help prevent flare-ups. Additionally, applying cool, damp dressings to the affected areas can soothe itching and inflammation during flare-ups. Consulting a healthcare professional is essential to develop a personalized treatment plan tailored to individual needs and circumstances. They can help manage Pompholyx eczema effectively and improve quality of life. Home remedy tips for Pompholyx eczema. Here are the shortened home remedy tips for Pompholyx eczema divided into four parts. Oatmeal baths and aloe vera. Soothe irritated skin and reduce itching with oatmeal baths and aloe vera gel, both known for their anti-inflammatory properties. Cold compresses and apple cider vinegar. Apply cold, damp compresses to reduce inflammation and use diluted apple cider vinegar to alleviate symptoms due to its anti-inflammatory and antimicrobial properties. Coconut oil and tea tree oil. Hydrate the skin and reduce inflammation by applying virgin coconut oil, and consider using diluted tea tree oil for its antibacterial and anti-inflammatory effects. Trigger avoidance and hydration. Identify and avoid triggers like stress and allergens, and maintain skin health by staying hydrated and drinking plenty of water. Frequently asked questions about Pompholyx eczema. Is Pompholyx eczema contagious? No, Pompholyx eczema is not contagious and cannot be spread from person to person. Can Pompholyx eczema be cured completely? While there is no known cure for Pompholyx eczema, symptoms can be effectively managed with proper treatment and preventive measures. What aggravates Pompholyx eczema? Common triggers for Pompholyx eczema include stress, sweating, exposure to allergens, and contact with irritants like detergents or metals. Is it safe to pop the blisters caused by Pompholyx eczema? It is not recommended to pop the blisters, as this can increase the risk of infection and delayed healing. Can diet affect Pompholyx eczema? While diet may play a role in some cases, there is limited scientific evidence linking specific foods to Pompholyx eczema. It is advisable to consult a healthcare professional for personalized dietary recommendations. Thanks for watching. Take care and stay safe.